Hey, Harland. Welcome to the Midweek Message. Today we're going to take a break from 1 John. I know we've been going verse by verse over the past few weeks. We're actually going to take a break because it's Thanksgiving. This is coming out the day before Thanksgiving. We're going to talk about Thanksgiving. We're going to take a look at this thing called thankfulness because God's kind of laid it on my heart that especially in 2020, we have a culture that is not being very thankful for things, and it's very easy to get so torqued up with what's going on in life that we lose sight of the things we can be thankful for. So I want to acknowledge that pink elephant, that hey, there are some things, that times when we are not very thankful, and I want to kind of do that today so that we can move forward in 1 John next week. And the verse I'm going to read this week is one we've been going through with the youth for the entire month of November. And it's 1 Thessalonians 5, verses 16 through 18. And it starts off and it says, "Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." It says, "Rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." And so can we be thankful in all circumstances? Not because of all circumstances. We don't have to be thankful because things are going on, but we can be thankful in all circumstances. And you know, it says in the Bible, this is God's will for you. This is 100% clear that it is God's will that you be thankful in all circumstances, regardless of what's going on. Regardless if our lead pastor has COVID, regardless if cases are rising, regardless if there's more restrictions, regardless if things are going virtual with schools and all the stuff that's going on around us, we can still be thankful in what's going on. And there's something inside us that knows that being thankful is what we want. And you know, we there are lots of benefits on why we should be thankful. And let me list some for you there. Thankfulness is God's will for you. I mean, it says that in the Bible. Thankfulness has extreme psychological benefits. I mean, psychology has all these activities they have you do about being thankful and prayer journals and other things and things that are secular about the benefits of thankfulness and the things that it produces in you. It proclaims our gratitude to God. You know, thankfulness is contagious. And nobody really wants to be around someone who's super ungrateful and super unthankful. They're not fun to be around. And thankfulness, lastly, portrays Christ to an ungrateful world. So thankfulness is something we definitely want, and we know we want that. But sometimes we kind of get messed up in our mind and think, you know what? There's so much going on that I'm not going to be thankful. And we don't even do it consciously. It just kind of becomes this little bitterness that kind of routes out inside of us and is like, ugh, and kind of squeezes out that thankfulness. So I'm going to give you a couple practical ways for us to kind of bring ourselves back into this area of thankfulness and really be able to experience what God has for us. And the first one is for us to write our blessings down. Write what we're thankful for. And I encourage you to take 15, 20 minutes to do that today. And start it by just have a full list of piece of paper and just kind of put down as many as you can. And then as more things come to your mind, continue to add those. And so you can have a list. We did this with the youth, and some youth started off with two or three, and then we said, okay, think about your family, think about your friends, think about your material possessions, think about your health, think about your school, think about the things you're involved in, think about the, and you just kind of went through a whole list of all the stuff. And we even said, think about what you're writing with right now. Think about the pen. You don't make the plastic. You don't make the ink. You don't make the spring. You don't make the metal that's in there to make this thing click when you click it on and off. Have you ever thanked God for even the pen that's in your hand and the fact that you don't have to chisel it out with a stone tablet? I mean, there's so much. Do you thank your God for hot water and that we have this miraculous thing called a faucet? You turn it on and water comes out. Do you thank God for even the little things that are in our lives? So and we did this with youth, and we had a couple people that front and back by period of 15 minutes had a full list of things. And the neat thing about this is that if you keep that list, then when you're starting to get out of whack, you're out of sync, you can go back to that list and you can say, know what, right now things are going on, but I'm going to be thankful to God. And here's why. And you can go back to that list. Thank God for this. Thank God for this. And it will recenter you with some thankfulness in your heart. Now, there's also sometimes when you may be totally out of sync and you even have your list next to you and you're like, I can't do this. And that's why God made each other. So another practical I have for you is that sometimes we need other people to speak truth in our lives because we are so out of whack with where we should be that we need other people to call us out and speak truth so that we can kind of get back into sync with what God has for us. So my care group, I have given specific permission to call things out in my life and speak truth. And so keep me accountable, keep me encouraged so that I can be fully functioning the way God wants me to with this spirit of thanksgiving, because that's God's will for us. I mean, it says, rejoice always, pray continually. It says, give thanks in all circumstances because this is Christ's, or the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. This is what God wants for you, is to have a thankful spirit, and the benefits that come from that psychologically are phenomenal. And it's kind of interesting, and I would say coincidental, that God has set things up that way, is that when your obedience to Him leads to these psychological benefits of peace and thankfulness and gratitude and just kind of a settling of our hearts. But that's a couple ways we can do that, is if we're starting to get out of whack, we have other people speaking to our lives and preparing a list of things that we're thankful for so that we can kind of combat that in the moment. And I encourage you to do that beforehand, because once you start actually getting out of whack, it's hard to come up with things you're thankful for. So I would do that now or today or tomorrow so that when those times come, you're prepared. I would prepare before the battle. Have a great week. We'll continue on with 1 John on Sunday.